Mr. Tarrou, congratulations on completing your AP Calculus AB course, but now comes the second phase of our studies, which is preparing to pass that AP test. We want that college credit to, represent, get a reward for all of that work we've put into this class over the last few months. And we're going to do something different for me. This is going to be, I'm going to start releasing some short form videos where we just do a couple of examples every couple of days, and I'm going to create a playlist of all of these lessons, of course, in sequence. I'm just randomly picking these problems, but I'll put them in sequence as I release them. Now, I'm not going to be creating some distractors or multiple choices for these questions, but they do represent, they are inspired by problems I've been using over the last 4 years to get my kids ready for their AP test. So here we go. Look forward to hopefully having you guys watch a lot more of these and, you know, get those fives that you deserve, like bam. So for an object moving in a straight line, the graph represents, this graph, represents the velocity of an object moving as a function of time. So the x-axis, if you will, is time, and the vertical scale is for the velocity. At which point is the speed the greatest? So do you remember how the speed and the velocity are related? The second question here is, at which of these points is the speed increasing? So take a minute, try and figure it out. I'm going to come back. I'm going to go over these questions, the answers, and then I'm going to summarize what I've said in a nice set of notes, and also make sure, I'll make sure that you have a link in the description if you want to go and look at a full-length lesson that is related to the concepts of whatever these questions happen to be about as we go through this series of videos. So, at which point is the speed the greatest? Well, velocity is positive if you're moving to the right or up, and negative if you're moving backwards. So we've got some positive velocities here at points A, B, and C, and negative velocities at points E, F, and G, because remember, the vertical scale is velocity. But since speed is the absolute value of velocity, this value of F, this point F, is the farthest point away from this sort of t-axis, if you will. So while it might be the lowest value for velocity being negative, since speed is again the absolute value, it's going to be the answer of F. This is when the speed is the greatest. Like your speedometer, the speedometer on your car does not differentiate between whether you're going forward or whether you're going backwards. If you go forwards in first gear, 5 miles an hour, speedometer says 5. You go backwards, still going to say 5. It's not going to reflect the fact that you're going in reverse. You better be looking over your shoulder. At which points is the speed increasing? Well, when does the speed of an object increase? The speed of an object increases when the velocity and acceleration have the same sign. So the velocity and acceleration have the same sign. So S of t is normally referred to as the position function. So F prime of t is equal to velocity. Okay, and this is the velocity function, right? We were told that this graph represents the velocity, not the position of the object. And then S double prime of t is equal to the derivative, or the first derivative, of velocity, which is equal to acceleration. So we need the velocity and the acceleration to have the same sign. Well, like at point A, the velocity is positive. And since acceleration is the derivative of velocity, and this has a positive slope, at point A, not only is the velocity positive, but so is the acceleration. So at point A, your speed is going to be increasing. At B, the acceleration is zero, because if I come in here and draw a tangent line, it's going to be horizontal. If I come here at C and draw a tangent line representing the slope, okay, the slope again of velocity is the acceleration. So we have a positive velocity but a negative acceleration at this point at that point C, this object, its speed is going to be decreasing. And now down here at E, the velocity graph is below the t-axis, so the velocity is going to be negative, but so is the slope. So if the velocity and the acceleration have the same sign, then that object is picking up speed. And so the final answer here, as far as at which points is the speed increasing, the speed is going to be increasing at A, because you have a positive velocity and a positive acceleration, and at E, because you have a negative velocity and a negative acceleration. And that's the end of our first review. Just I'm going to walk out, pause the video, write a bunch of notes to kind of summarize what I just said. And if any of this sounded not very familiar, check out the description and you'll find a link to that full-length lesson. I'm Mr. Tarrou. Bam! Go get that A or that 5, like bam!